Presidente, Tropicans await elections next year. They wish to show their everlasting love and respect for you. They may have used different words, but that does not matter.
I might have been just a touch off in my careful, calculated predictions.
Presidente, I encountered a hostile atom today. It was attached to a hostile punch, attached to a hostile arm, attached to a hostile lady. This was clearly a provocation. I have declared a war on all atoms. I propose we use neutrons to split their forces.
Good day.
Presidente, I am overjoyed that you chose this means to end the war, as are all militarists. We have an opportunity to influence the outcome. The election results are in. Let me be the first to congratulate you.
The Politburo has proclaimed eternal friendship between the USSR and Tropico. The bad news is I got kissed by at least two Russians.
Mr. President, according to my calculations, the Tropican economy will reach the point of collapse.
Something most unexpected has happened, old boy. Those inconspicuous parts from the Soviets turned out to be missiles. Thank you. Our man in the USSR has been invited to a drinking contest with the Russians. The Russians want to start. The Politburo has proclaimed eternal friendship between the USSR and...
Comrade Presidente, during the war... It seems I keep underestimating your capabilities.
The Politburo has approved our flu. The Politburo has proclaimed it. Russians.
Have you seen the statistics? It seems I keep underestimating your capabilities.
Our relations with the great Soviet Union are now in the eternal friendship phase. This means we are eternally friend-zoned.
Did it have to be the USSR, old chap? Couldn't we have sent a delegation to somewhere warmer?
My calculations show that there's more to be milked from this tourist invasion.
We have been invited to establish a bloody good job on this whole peace affair. Really brought tears to my eyes.
I knew you were a communist hiding behind a non-communist facade. A true comrade.
Greetings, old chap. Have I got a deal for you today? As Crown representative, I can offer you your very own trading license. Thank you. His Majesty needs money to build a new underwater palace. He wants you to begin growing money. I mean, one of those crops that make heaps of cash. His Royal Majesty has instructed me to present you with this letter of commendation for your achievements in the name of the Empire.
Technological progress is the path to autonomy, Governor.
His Majesty has commissioned the finest architects to design his new underwater home. We need your cash crops to pay for them. My good fellow, I have it from a very reliable source that there be gold in them there hills, boy. I suggest you send some men to find it.
Great news! While searching through the crates of colony supplies, we found a sickle! Now we have something that goes perfectly with our hammers. This will boost production sky high. I can almost see the glorious future.
His Royal Majesty has instructed me to present you with this letter of commendation for your achievements in the name of the Empire.
Someone stole my manuscript and published it under a pseudonym. It was an autobiographical story about two men on a mountain who want to form deep male bonds. They even stole the surrealistic chapter where fairies prance under a rainbow. The circumstances behind the theft are very queer.
There was gold in those mountains. Jolly good, old chap. Thank you.
freedom will never simply be given to us. We must take it by force. We need to train our own soldiers. Soldiers that are ready to fight and die for our homeland.
Presidente. Ooh, I'm getting ahead of myself. Governor, the island is ripe for revolution. Our research team, that is to say me, discovered the shovel 40 times. If I find out who put it there, I will kill him. Anyway, I gave it to the miners so they can put it somewhere safe, like underground.
In a flash of brilliance, His Royal Majesty figured out how to fix all of your island's problems through the construction of a single building.
Presidente, as you know, it is your will alone that keeps Tropico together. Without you, the entire island would crumble to dust and be lost forever. As the heir was born, all animals became quiet. A light shone through the skies, and La Chupacabra herself went to the crib and bowed to the infant. At least, that is what we will write in the history books. Thank you.
Thanks to your efforts, the revolutionary movement is growing stronger.
Great news! We found out how to use the muskets the Crown sent us. Apparently, all you have to do is pull the trigger. Our research was seriously hindered until we discovered you should not look into the barrel when pulling the trigger. We lost a lot of good men that way.
Tropico itself has given us a way to gain our independence. I am talking about gold. Mother Earth will gladly sacrifice her precious gifts for our freedom.
I sat with three other members of the research team. Suddenly, it dawned on us. We're four men. You get it? Four men? Incidentally, we also discovered bad puns.
His Royal Majesty has instructed me to present you with this.
Our soldiers may be few in number, but the fire of the revolution burns in their hearts. We need more brave men and women like them.
Just discovered the number of times you need to get hit by a plank to actually discover something. It is around 7.
His Majesty's plans have been hindered.
Thank you.
Presidente, after suffering 1,000 paper cuts, we have invented...
His Royal Majesty has instructed me to present you with this letter of commendation for your achievements in the name of the Empire.
Thanks to your efforts, the revolutionary movement is growing stronger.
Construction of His Majesty's underwater palace has begun. The Crown requires a great many tons of your crops to help pay for this massive project.
We have invented red tape. It goes well with everything, and there is no limit to this stuff. People are going crazy over it. Lines are forming to get more of it. It almost seems like it is trying to grow bigger and bigger, all on its own.
His Majesty is furious. He has just learned that you've begun mustering a sizable army, yet you don't have a major general. Appoint one immediately.
Disaster. The revolutionaries are demanding that you insult the king. We will send the king a gift that will insult him greatly.
The king is extremely grateful for the gift you sent him. Collecting chamber pots is a hobby of his, and yours is a piece he did not have. Crowded. It is full of lost cities, rich American industrialists, and sleeping alien gods. His Majesty has no desire to mingle with such things.
No.
We, the leaders of the Tropican nation, in our desire to put into words the will of the Tropican people to follow and obey the laws of the state and maintain the traditional universal Tropican values of liberty, peace, love, understanding, siesta, and hidden Swiss bank accounts, do hereby sign the first legitimate constitution of Tropico.
The Tropican soldier is brave. The Tropican soldier is...
Good thing I didn't place a bet on this. These chaps actually look serious about this whole detente thing.
Comrade Presidente, your decision to join the struggle alongside our Soviet brothers fills my heart with joy.
Presidente! My career as a weatherman is over. I promised everyone a warm and sunny day. And now we have a tornado on the island. I am back in the game. I can now accurately predict.
Presidente?
Thank you.